Back with another multi-tool. This one from 1876. Registered by Mr. Lester Beach. This tool titled Combination Implement. This one purports 10 tools in one. We're really moving up in the world now. We've got a hammer, an ice pick, a sort of prying tool and a screwdriver. We have a wrench cut through the middle here. Knife sharpener. We have rules in both metric and inchy poos on either side. We have a pot hook and also a nail remover / stove lid lifter. Unlike everything else in this series so far, while there's again no record of this device going into manufacture, there is a live example that's been found out in the wild with the same patent date on it. So somebody went to the trouble of casting this thing in some quantity. Given the presence of the dimensions on the tool itself, we know that this is about 300 or 400 mil long. It's about 13 inches for you. Metrically challenged. This looks like a fairly simple design. However, given that this was likely designed to be cast in one piece, with the exception of the knife sharpener here, we're going to have to do what I like to call additive subtractive specialist manufacturing, or ASS manufacturing. This is where I get a chunk of steel, mill half of it off, and then weld a bunch of crap back on. Generally, it doesn't achieve a very pretty result, but it sure is fun. Now, before we get started with the build, it looks like we now actually have some subscribers. Welcome, guys and girls. I really do appreciate your subscription. It's both humbling and makes this whole experience a little less like screaming into the void. As we go on, I'll be sure to organise some giveaways, something like that, to make sure you feel my appreciation. As always, at the end of this video, we'll review this tool and give our completely unfair and scathing 21st century critiques of this honest 19th century design. So let's go ahead and see if I can make it. Awesome. You know, I only first touched a milling machine of any kind about 4 weeks ago, and I've got to tell you, I'm learning the hard way about the importance of those finishing passes. There's certainly a lot of additional finishing work that could be done to this thing, but you know, there's really only so much lipstick you can throw at a pig. So what do we think of this magical 10-in-1 multi-tool? It's fairly straightforward, as we went through before, you know, with hammerhead, pointy thing, pointy thing, pointy thing, pointy thing, pointy thing, and of course a ruler on the body. But add them together and you get a really, really terrible tool. First and foremost, by design, this pot holder or pot carrier actually sticks out in front of the hammerhead. So that's fine if you're up hammering something on an angle or in a vise or something, but as soon as you start trying to hit something on a work surface or a wall, that pot hook hits the work surface first. So this pretty much renders the hammerhead useless in most cases. The ice pick, well, again, this pot hook gets in the way if you're trying to swing this thing. Just jams up into your wrist. That's not incredible. The ruler, as you can see, because the hammerhead is a hammerhead, we can't actually lay this tool flat on anything. So unless you're to hang it off the bench and use it like that, maybe. But really, you can only use sort of 70% of the ruler. You know, even... Oh, and the pointy bits are fine, I guess. You know, if we were to presume that all these elements actually work together and weren't completely unnecessary, this would still be a very silly design. And I guess we really need to quantify what actually makes a good multi-tool. If we start up by looking at something like this, these welding pliers. These have a combination narrow pliers, a wire cutter, two different size of grips, and these little hammering notches. What makes this a useful tool is that they all serve a purpose when you're doing a single job. You know, you're likely to use one or more of these elements while you're welding something. The grips here and here, especially sized for the nozzle and the inside tip for your welding torch. Wire cutters, because you're forever cutting the wire down to size. These little hammering notches for knocking off any slag. You know, they're all used for the one type of job. This thing, as with pretty much all the designs we've looked at in this series so far, they're completely disjointed. You know, I've never been hammering something and then desperately needed to find my ice pick or my knife sharpener. Or, for that matter, carry a hot pot of soup somewhere. Maybe if you had to chip some ice, smash it up with a hammer and then measure the puddle and then carry that puddle in a pot somewhere. You know, maybe this might be the tool for you, but outside of that, I don't think this would ever be very particularly useful. And I mean, metal handles on percussive tools aren't a great idea. Anyway, thanks for joining me. If you enjoyed this content, please let me know down in the comment section. Subscribe if you haven't already, and give us a like so we can continue making these videos. I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers.